हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर मिश्रामकर सुनित्रा फ्रॉम JAT आर्ट्स साइंस एंड कॉमर्स कॉलेज डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश मालेगांव। माय प्रेजेंटेशन इज ऑन पैलेंकिन बियरर्स बाय सरोजिनी नायडू। पैलेंकिन बियरर्स, Sarojini Naidu was born on February 13, 1879 in Hyderabad. She was a political activist and played an active role in freedom struggle of India. She was the first Indian woman to become the president of Indian National Congress. In 1947, she became the governor of United Provinces, that is UP. She retained this position till her death. She died in 1949. Apart from her political career, she was also an avid poetry writer. For her beautiful poetry, she has been lovingly called the Nightingale of India. Some of her major contributions are The Golden Threshold and The Bird of Time. In 1914, she was elected as a fellow of the Royal Society of Literature. Sarojini Naidu has written so many beautiful poems. She has presented her feelings through her poems. Here, in the present poem, she has presented the beautiful picture of a bride carried by palanquin bearers. Now dear students, here you can see this image. Here are the palanquin bearers. A newly wedded bride is sitting in this palanquin. So palanquin bearers means palki vahak. First we'll have the text of this poem. Palanquin bearers. Lightly
we bear her along. She sways like a flower in the wind of a song. She skims like a bird on the foam of a stream. She floats like a laugh from the lips of a dream. Gaily, oh gaily we glide and we sing. We bear her along like a pearl on a string. Softly, oh softly, we bear her along. She hangs like a star in the dew of her song. She springs like a beam on the brow of the tide. She falls like a tear from the eyes of a bride. Lightly, oh lightly, we glide and we sing. We bear her along like a pearl on a string.
Palanquin Bearer is a melodious poem. The poem describes the scene of a bride being carried on a palanquin. The poem generates images of royal wives being carried on a palanquin to their husband's house. The men who carried the palanquin felt that their job was special and they did it with much happiness. Here, this poem is a melodious poem and it is appealing poem. This poem describes the beauty of bride while she is being carried in a palanquin. We are reminded of one of the ancient custom of carrying royal brides in India. Those brides were carried in decorated carriages to their husband's home. Occasionally, the men of the royal families would travel on horseback along with the bride. The men who carried the carriages were happy about their work and they believed that they had a distinguished job. They did not feel their job burdensome. The poem is written in such a way
that one can see and feel as if the palanquin is moving. The poet brings in so many images describing the movement of the palanquin. The word which Sarojini Naidu has used seem to have a magic touch. In short, we can say that the liberal use of imagery, mainly similes, make this poem a pictorial delight. So, dear students, we can visualize the imagery of moving palanquin through the use of similes. The poem is being sung by palanquin bearers. They have got the esteemed job of carrying the bride. While carrying the palanquin on their shoulders, they are singing song. Here, in the first stanza, the poet says, "Lightly, oh lightly, we bear her along. She's faced like a flower in the wind of her song." Here the poet says that the bride sways with the movement of the palanquin, just like a flower sways in the wind. She is so light that they compare her to a bird that skims on the foaming foam. So, in the first stanza, the bride is compared with a flower. Flower is very delicate, and here this palanquin bearers say that the newly wedded bride is just like a flower that sways in the wind. Later on, the poet says, "She skims like a bird on the foam of a stream. She skims like a bird on the foam of a stream. She floats like a laugh from the lips of a dream." Here, the palanquin bearers compare the newly wedded bride to a bird that skims on the foaming froth of the stream. She is ethereal, just like a tender laugh. So, here the poet says that the bird which is carried away by those palanquin bearers is really very, very beautiful, and they like their job. Now here, the palanquin bearers carry the bride so softly and delicately as if she were something very delicate, very soft and very precious. They carry her softly. This poem is a musical poem. Here we can experience the journey of the newly wedded bride. The poet says that the newly wedded bride floats like a laugh from the lips of a dream. She is very beautiful. She is so soft. She is so delicate. She is delicate, just like the smile of a small child. Gaily, oh gaily, we glide and we sing. Gaily means happily. Happily, we glide and we sing. The palanquin bearers are very happy. They like their job. They have feeling that they have got the esteemed job of carrying the bride. While carrying the palanquin on their shoulders, they are very, very happy. Therefore, they say, "Gaily, oh gaily, we glide when we sing. We bear her along like a pearl on a string." So here the poet has used very beautiful imagery. She has described this movement as if these palanquin bearers are carrying her just like a delicate pearl. In the next stanza, the poet says,
Softly, oh softly, we bear her along. She hangs like a star in the dew of her song. Here the poet has used the imagery of star. She is so light that they compare her to a star. She is just like a star, and they carry her softly on their shoulders. The bride is compared to a star that is reflected in the soft dew drops. She is so brightly clad that she appears to be a shining beam of light that is reflected from the surface of waves. At the same time, she is so tender and delicate that they compare her to a gentle drop of tear. Here, in the next stanza, the poet says, she springs like a beam on the brow of a tide. She springs like a beam on the brow of the tide. She falls like a tear from the eyes of a bride. So here, the bride is very soft. She is so delicate. She is so tender and delicate that they compare her to a gentle drop of tear that falls from the eyes of bride. Here we get picture of the bride crying softly. She is leaving the house of her loved ones. She is leaving the house of her father, and she is going to start a new life. The palanquin bearers sing happily. They are smoothly carrying that palanquin, and they are smoothly carrying the bride. Here, she is compared to a precious jewel. She is said as if a precious jewel willing to be possessed by her husband. Now here in this poem, the poet has deliberately used contradictory feelings of laughing and weeping. The bride is sad and she is crying. She is sad because she is separated from her family. But at the same time, she is happy. She is overjoyed because she is starting a new life. In Indian culture, earlier women were considered as a burden. But when the palanquin bearers carry the bride as she is married, they feel no burden because of the environment. In older times, each and every parent wanted to get their daughters happily married. Carrying a palanquin of a bride was considered as a privilege. And in this poem, Sarojini Naidu has presented this beautiful custom of Indian society. Here the poet says, lightly, oh lightly, we bear her along. She sways like a flower in the wind of her song. Here, the poet compares her with a delicate flower. And in the last stanza of this poem, the poet says that lightly, oh lightly, we glide and we sing, we bear her along like a pearl on a string. So, the bride in this poem is just like a very, very precious jewel. She is carried very softly and she is carried very smoothly by the palanquin bearers. Here is about the Indian culture. The poet has deliberately used certain images. Furthermore, the poet has used similes also. So, palanquin bearer is a musical poem. there is vivid description of the journey, and this journey makes us experience of soft and gentle swaying movements of the palanquin. The swaying movements of the palanquin are compared to flower, they are compared to star, they are compared to pearl. The bride is very delicate, just like a pearl on a string, and therefore these bearers do not feel the burden of the bride, and they move with quick steps like the birds that skim across the river without touching the water. Here the poet has used very beautiful imagery in this poem. In the first stanza, the poet has said that she floats like a laugh. This conveys the joy of anticipation, because she is happy, she is going to a new house, her husband's house. Her heart is full of excitement, and the palanquins are moving towards the house of her soulmate. In the second stanza, the poet compares the bride to a tear falling from the eyes of bride. Here it gives a touch of sadness to the description. Here it describes the state of bride's mind. She is sad because she is separated from her parents and from her family. The poet has used variety of literary devices. The poem is full of descriptive similes. The bride is compared to objects known for their beauty, delicacy, worth and brightness. The variety of similes used offer modesty and beauty to the sweet occasion when the bride is being carried to her husband's house. The poet has used repetition to give musical effect to this poem. This repetition offers sweetness also. The rhythm of the poem is even and it is swift. The poet has used the close rhyme scheme, and it has added lyricism to the poem. The poet has used alliteration, pictorial quality and imagery. And because of it, this poem is a very beautiful poem. So here we get a beautiful picture of a newly wedded bride being carried by palanquin bearers. Thank you.